Steve Bannon recently appeared at an event of crazies to say a crazy thing. He claimed that Joe Biden's recent effort to help humanity beat cancer is actually designed to eliminate humans. Take a look.
We're gonna get to a point where you're gonna have human 2.0, right? They're telling you that. They're funding that. This is not science fiction. This is fact. This is what they're working on. This is the underpinnings of what the World Economic Forum and the Great Reset's about. They all want to live forever. Immortality, don't they talk about they're going to save kids and they're going to do, that's all crap. They want to be immortal, right? And they also say there's too many people, the carrying capacity of this planet, there's too many people, right? So we got to figure out how we're going to do here. You know, they're all over Tucker and the great replacement theory and about the thing. Hey, the great replacement theory is Homo sapiens. That's what they're trying to replace. They're going to have their deal and devil catch the hindmost. And people saying, well, hold it. I haven't heard about that. Of course you haven't heard about it. They don't want to talk about it. They're just going to do it. And they're going to call it the cancer moonshot.
So that is a rant about how Joe Biden is going to replace humans 1.0 with humans 2.0, delivered by a guy that, based on appearance, at best is humans 0.75. Like, I don't think we're quite the same thing. But anyway, what does Biden actually want to do? Super fast, because this is actually important. He has a cancer moonshot. He wants to reduce cancer death rates by half within 25 years. Little things like encouraging people to get regular cancer screenings or participate in clinical trials. He wants to increase development of and access to new cancer drugs, probably subsidize them as well, and ensure access to cancer care. And in a world, a country where cancer is one of the biggest killers, yes, we would prefer to be able to defeat cancer, to stop it from taking so many people's lives, including children's lives, by the way. What that has to do with living forever, I don't know. He can ask Jared Kushner. He's the dude talking about that a lot recently. And how that is attached to overall world populations. These are separate concerns. None of it has to do with creating a new species. But this is how they can turn literally anything the government does that would actually potentially benefit you or people you know. They cloak it all in conspiracy theories. They poison the well for people actually having optimism and hope for the future and a belief that if we work together, we can actually improve the world.
Yeah, I love that this guy is trying to say, watch out, the rich people have evil plans, when he himself has back end on Seinfeld syndication money. Like, he's the rich guy. And look, by the way, all the people who are rallying you as minions are elite. They're the whatever better thans or whatever weird ass term he used. And also baked into his argument is nothing should ever get better.
Yep.
He's like, oh, isn't it terrible? Basically, replace humans with iPhones. He's like, we should keep the iPhone 1 forever. It'll be great. They don't want any of that. And at the same time, they say that a private industry is gonna, you know, we're gonna have improvements baked into capitalism, but it's like that's you are only against curing cancer. Like, that is how insane they are that Steve Bannon boldly came out against curing cancer, and that's the kind of clarity I appreciate from him. Actually, he doesn't want to cure cancer. Thanks, dude. And the last thing I'll say is corporatists. Like him, the opposite of what he's saying, the corporatists are the ones who are actually killing the poor people. Because with a lack of corporate regulations, the corporations are going to do whatever the hell they want, which is basically poison small towns full of blue collar workers. And we've seen that time and time again and never do anything to fix it. So his situation already does all the things he's trying to scare people are in the future.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.